Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station whereby we are going to learn, experience and also interact together. We are going to have our mathematics from 4, lesson 14, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. And we are going to handle the topic on statistics 2 under the subtopic mean using a working mean. So here we are going to assume a certain working mean. Before that, we are going to have the following lesson objectives, whereby by the end of this lesson, you should be able to calculate mean of a given set of data. Let us begin all through the lesson, and we shall enjoy. We are going to have our first example, whereby you are given some certain masses. The masses to the nearest kilogram of 40 students in a Form 4 class were measured and recorded in the table below. So you are required to calculate the mean mass. Here it is being tabulated. We have got the mass and also the frequency. So for the kg or the students who are weighing 47 kgs, they were 2. The students who were weighing 48 kgs, and that is 0, that is to mean there were no students whose weight was 48. For the 49, we have got 1, and so forth, as you can see from our screen. Also for the 51, we have 3, 52, we have 2, 53, we have 5 students, 54, we have 6 students, 55, we have 7 students, 56, we have 5 students, 57, we have 3, and so forth. So now we are required to calculate the mean. Now I've come and we have decided to tabulate our information on our table. As you can see here, we are saying that you let us use a working mean of 53. So that is to mean we are going to arrange our masses, as you can see, from 47 to 60, and we have got t, whereby in this case our t we are going to get is our x, and x in our case is the mass of the kgs. We subtract the assumed mean, and our assumed mean is 53. So that is to mean on our first step, we have taken 47, we subtract 53, we are getting a negative 6. Our second step, we are taking 48, we subtract 53, we get negative 5. 49, we subtract 53, we are getting a negative 4, as you can see from our screen, and we continue so forth till we reach at around 54, we subtract 53. So as you can see, we have got some negative values, and we still have got positive values. So we are going up to 60, whereby you 60 you subtract 53 for you to get 7. We have got another column of frequency, and our frequency is being represented by F. So now for the frequency, what you normally do, as you can see from a previous table, for the frequency it's already given, so you just write the frequencies that are being given, and at the lower end we have got a summation of f. The sign that you can see there is actually used to represent summation of something. So in our case, our sign there is representing summation of f, that is, and our f is representing frequency. So the total frequency here is 40. And then we have got another column whereby we are going to get your frequency, which is f, we multiply by our t. So that is, we are getting ft. So now we are getting negative 6, we multiply by 2 to get negative 12. We also get negative 5, which is our t, and our f is 0. To get 0, and you multiply until the last value, whereby you are getting the last value whereby we are having 1, not 1, actually 7, you multiply by 1 to get 7. So and still we also get its summation, that is summation of that column, to get your 40. So here to get this 40 is coming from, we are adding negative 12 plus 0, negative 4, negative 6. You can use your calculator or you can do it manually, so that at least you arrive at negative 40. Now when we come to calculation of the same, here we are getting the mean of t. So to get our mean of t, you are getting to get summation of ft, we divide by summation of f. So that is to mean you are getting 40, we divide by 40 to get 1. And now to get the overall mean, we are going to get our assumed mean, whereby we said that we assume that our working mean is 53, then we are going to get, we add it to the mean of t, which is 1. So actually our overall mean, we are going to get 53 plus 1, which is 54. We can look at another example whereby you are required to calculate the mean of the following data, and the data is given as follows. That is 670, 671, 672, and so forth, as you can see from our screen. So here, what you normally do, actually, you just make a certain table. Then we have got, you arrange the data which with the column of X, and we have got T. Here, we are using an assumed mean of 500. So to get our T, you're just going to get our X, which is, as you can see, our X. Then we subtract from 500. As you can see, we have got negative values and also the positive values. So at the end, we are going to get the summation of T, which is 20. From there, we are going to calculate, whereby we are going to get mean of T, and remember that we have got an assumed mean of 500. So we are going to get summation of T, which we have gotten as 20. You divide by 18 to get 1.11. Then actually, yeah, this 18 is the total frequency. If you can, the total frequency. So the total frequency, you just count the number of figures that are there. Now to get our overall mean, we are going to get 500 plus the mean of t, that is 501. Having said that, we are required to have the following activity. Remember, you should find the mean of the following numbers, as you can see from the screen. And to get more information in this lesson, you can refer to KLB. Secondary Mathematics Student Book 4, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, and it has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. And to get this mathematics lesson and many more, you can send us an SMS within the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to both our YouTube and Facebook page, which are both Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV underscore KE. Let us subscribe to all this channel, and you shall enjoy more of our mathematics lessons. Thank you.